Brothers and sisters, many of our brothers and sisters are getting ready to make their journey to Hajj. Within this couple of weeks, many of them will be going to attend the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the ihram. This is a big journey in the life. This is not a holiday. We need serious preparation. We need Hajj training. We need to have our spiritual uplifting. We need to do tawbah from our sins. We need to know the history of that piece of land. We need to know the significance of the house of Allah, the status of it. We must respect honor of this house of Allah and this holy city, Wal Baladul Amin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this town is not an ordinary town. He made qasam twice, swear by this town twice in the kitab of Allah in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it. This hajj of this town, this house is very important. As he, after building this house, he said to Ibrahim alayhi salam, O Ibrahim, and proclaim to the people the hajj. They will come to you on foot and on every lean camel. They will come from every distant pass that they may witness benefits for themselves. Going there will witness benefit for us. What benefit it is? To increase iman in Allah. To have a spiritual uplifting to happen to us. To commit tawbah from the sins we have committed. And to be motivated to more ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the best town, best piece of land in this whole planet. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was leaving this Mecca in the time of Hijrah, he was crying out of love of Mecca. He's leaving this beloved city. He's saying, oh, by Allah, indeed, oh Mecca, you are the best land of Allah and best place of land to Allah. If it is not that I was forced to leave, I will never leave you. This is the Ummul Qura, Allah has given title, mother of all localities. All towns and villages are branches of this main city and town of Mecca, center of the whole world. In it, there are signs of Allah, symbols of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يُعَذِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. And whoever honors the symbols of Allah, indeed, it is from the piety of hearts. If you feel there, you are not committing sins. You are more close to Allah. You respect these all symbols of Allah by not committing sin. It is a sign you have taqwa. But if you are there and you still commit sin, there is no difference between Mecca and any other place in your mind, then there is no taqwa. This weakness of taqwa. Taqwa is little. This is clear sign. The symbols of Allah is what? This very house of Allah is the symbols of Allah. This is the first house built in this planet to worship Allah. In awwala baytin wudi'a lin-nas alladhi bi Makkah. Okay? Indeed, the first house of worship established for mankind was that of at Makkah, which is under the name of Makkah. Blessed and a guidance for the world. It is in it are clear signs such as the standing place of Abraham, Maqam Ibrahim, and whoever enters it shall be saved. Many signs of Allah and symbols. House of Allah, Maqam Ibrahim, Al-Hajr al-Aswad, the black stone, Al-Rukn al-Yamani, Zamzam is the biggest sign of Allah, a miracle from where millions of people, billions of people could be drinking and taking to their buckets, to the containers, to the various parts of the world. It is not coming to the end. It is a miracle. It is a clear sign of Allah. From one well, all this water is coming and never stopped. And Safa Marwa, the story, the history of Ibrahim alayhi salam leaving his son Ismail, the baby, and his mother, the baby's mother, together there, and Allah is taking care of them. All this story. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born there and he was brought up there. He received the wahi there and faced all this persecution of Kufar Makkah, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given him victory all these signs are there. These, all this to increase our iman. We know we should read the history. We should know the significance of the every symbol of Allah. So we respect, and we are always in mood of ibadah and controlling ourselves from all kind of sins. It's very part of our taqwa and very important in this journey of Hajj. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned people to commit any kind of sin there. It's a very big crime committing sin over there. Not only that, if you have intention of committing sin there, you could not perform it, could not commit it even. You just have an intention itself is a crime. As it said in Surah Al-Hajj 25, وَمَنْ يُرَدْ فِيهِ بِإِلْحَادٍ بِذُلْمٍ نُذِقْهُ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. And whoever intends a deed therein of deviation by wrongdoing, will make him taste of a painful punishment. Imam Ibn Kathir, rahmatullah alayhi, in the tafsir of this ayah, he said that مَنْ هَمَّ أَنْ يَعْمَلَ سَيِّئَةً بِمَكَّةٍ أَذَاقَهُ اللَّهُ الْعَذَابَ الْأَلِيمِ بِسَبَبِ هَمِّهِ بِذَلِكِ وَإِنْ لَمْ يَفْعَلْهَا بخلاف غير الحرم المكي من البقاع فلا يعاقب فيه بالهم. So anybody is just intending to commit a sin over there, that is enough to be committing a sin by intention. In any other place in the world, if you have intention but you did not do it, there is no sin for you. Allah will forgive it. But in Mecca, just intention could bring a punishment of Allah to you and it will be considered as a sin. And you know the hadith or the surah Al-Fil, where Abraha, the king of Habasha, wanted to destroy this house of Allah. This crime was dealt with the severe punishment never witnessed in this world by any other criminals. وَأَرْسَلَ عَلَيْهِمْ طَيْرًا أَبَابِيلَ تَرْمِيهِمْ بِحِجَارَةٍ مِّنْ سِجِّيلٍ. And he sent against them birds in flocks, striking them with stones of hard clay, and he made them like eaten straw, smashed them. They say, many of the scholars said, Ibn Mas'ud radhiyallahu anhu narrated a hadith, لو أن رجلا هم فيه بإلحاد أو هو بعدن أبين قرية على جانب البحر ناحية اليمن لَأَذَاقَهُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ عَذَابًا عَلِيمًا. In this hadith, if anybody far away from Mecca in Yemen, a city is mentioned, is intending to commit a sin in Mecca, even though he couldn't reach Mecca, neither he committed, he will be even punished by Allah. Umar radiallahu anhu was warning in one occasion, people of Mecca, residents of Mecca, who were gone there to stay some time to do Hajj or Umrah, he said, يَا أَهْلَ مَكَّةَ الله الله في حرم الله إن هذا البيت كان وليه ناس قبلكم فعصوا ربهم واستحلوا حرمته فأهلكهم ثم وليه آخرون فعصوا ربهم واستحلوا حرمته فأهلكهم لأن أختي 70 خطية بركبة وهي واد معروف قرب الطائف أحب إلي من أن أختي خطية واحدة في الحرم. He said, O people of Mecca, be aware of the honor of Mecca. Many people are given responsibility to stay here, to reside here, to take responsibility of this house, but they do commit sin. They gone against the adab of this house and all the symbols of Allah. Then Allah punished them. Then other people came. Again, they did all this wrongdoing. Allah punished them. Then he said, if I commit 70 sins somewhere else, in Taif, a city, Rukba, much better than committing one single sin in Mecca. He said, one sin in Mecca is worse than committing 70 sins somewhere else. So when you go to Hajj and Umrah, brothers and sisters, we have to be careful of not using any of our organs to commit any sin. Very easiest one is tongue and the eyes, our sights. Easily talking something and quarreling and hurting people and backbiting and looking and not lowering our gaze could bring big disaster to us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. When people go for Hajj, I can see in the Ihram period, maybe most of people are okay, controlled. Once they take off Mihram, إحرام in the 10th day in Mina or 11th day, you'll see they are in holiday mood. No more this spirit of Ihram and Hajj and Umrah. It is almost over. Any day you stay there, you must observe this adab of House of Allah and this holy city. So we need to read all this history about all the symbols of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and learn the manners. And we ask Allah tawfiq. Praying one rak'ah there, giving reward of 100,000 rak'ah. Anywhere else. Similar way, is increase Quran recitation or any other dua, zikr, tasbih, tawaf, everything is multiplied many times. And sin is also multiplied. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect for us from committing sin over there. Wabillahi tawfiq. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا وأتوبوا إليه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم